What's up, everybody? I'm Seth Fowler, and today I'm reviewing the white colorway of the Nike Off-White VaporMax. Thanks so much for tuning in today. Make sure to subscribe down below if you haven't yet and want to see more reviews just like this one. Also, make sure to give me a follow on Instagram and on Twitter at RealSethFowler. But with all that out of the way, let's get into it. If you guys hear any noises in the background, it's because I procrastinated filming this video until nighttime and now there's a thunderstorm. So that's great. Some of you may remember from a couple months back, I did an early review of this particular colorway of the Off-White VaporMax at Sneakerflea. And even though I was pretty happy with how that review came out, that wasn't actually my personal pair, so I wasn't able to do an on-feet and I wasn't able to give you guys my thoughts after actually wearing the shoe. So now, thanks to the app Bump, I actually have a pair to review and I'm really excited. If you haven't seen my Bump pickup video where I got this pair and a couple other pieces of hype clothing like some Supreme CD stuff, some Palace stuff, make sure to check it out at the link at the top of the screen. Nike's been collaborating with Off-White since late last year and we've gotten a bunch of silhouettes out of this collaboration. I've been able to grab a couple of them, but until now I wasn't able to grab an Off-White VaporMax. And I'm sure some of you guys are going, but Seth, you hate the VaporMax. And while that's not totally untrue, I don't love the silhouette, I think certain colorways and certain iterations of the shoe actually look pretty good. I've owned maybe three or four different pairs of the VaporMax, all of which I've gotten rid of, but I think I might finally have a pair that I'm gonna keep. So without further ado, here it is, the white colorway of the Nike Off-White VaporMax. Jumping right into this sneaker, just like almost every other VaporMax, the base construction of the upper is made up of Flyknit. Obviously on this colorway, the Flyknit comes in a bright white. Out of the three Off-White VaporMaxes that have dropped, I think this is probably my second favorite. And the reason this shoe made number two on the list is because I actually like the way the white looks better than the all black version. I just think it's more interesting to look at. However, because it is all white and Flyknit is pretty absorbent, it's definitely gonna get dirty very quickly. Oh, and if you were still wondering, my favorite Off-White VaporMax colorway is the original colorway. I just really like the white swoosh and the white tongue. It just looks really great. Continuing with this sneaker, around the edge of the toe, you've got some clear fuse overlay for added durability. There's also a large piece of fuse overlay that starts just behind the toe and wraps all the way around the sneaker. If you don't already own a pair of VaporMax, one thing to keep in mind is that the Flyknit around the toe is very loosely knit. And because of that, the ventilation holes are very large, so no matter what color sock you're wearing, you're gonna see it through your shoe. So in my case, I try and wear a matching color sock to the upper of the sneaker. So with this shoe, I wear white socks. With the black VaporMax, I wear black socks. Or hey, if you wanna try something a little bit different, like a blue sock to match these laces, that's not a bad way to go either. Continuing up the shoe, you find this tan short suede panel around the eyelets of the sneaker. This panel construction is only found on the Off-White VaporMax and not the regular VaporMax. And I personally really like the way that it looks. I think it adds this nice simple sophistication to the top of the sneaker. I think it looks great. Continuing up the shoe, you've got these thin white flywire strands holding the laces in place. This colorway of the Off-White VaporMax usually comes with white laces, but I really love the way the blue laces looked, so I switched them out. And in my opinion, I think these laces look way better. As we've come to expect from the Nike Off-White collection, each pair of laces comes with the word shoelaces written at the top of each lace. Just below the laces, you've got a white foam tongue with these pill-shaped perforations throughout. At the top of the tongue, you've got your white Nike sportswear tag with the orange swoosh. Another one of Virgil's signature touches on the Off-White collection is the unfinished tongue. Inside the sneaker, the sock liner is just the other side of the white Flyknit. You've also got a white insole with the Off-White and the 10 branding printed on the heel. As for fit, the Off-White VaporMax fits just like any other regular VaporMax. For me, that's true to size, but for you, it might be something different. One thing to keep in mind is that the VaporMax does usually tend to run a little bit thin, so if you have wider feet, maybe go up half a size. But if you're still unsure, it doesn't hurt to go down to the local sneaker store, try on a pair of VaporMax, and see what size works best for you. Continuing back on the lateral side of the sneaker, you've got this clear plastic swoosh that's stitched on with white thread. On the tail of the swoosh, you've also got this little neon orange accent stitched in. Just below that, you've got the word Air written in quotation marks right on the heel. Moving around to the medial side of the sneaker, you've got another clear Nike swoosh, and behind that, printed on the midfoot of the shoe, is your signature Off-White paragraph. One thing that's always kind of gotten to me on the Off-White VaporMax is that when they print on the Flyknit, the printing just doesn't turn out to look that good. You can see when the printing lands on the fuse overlay, it comes out super sharp and clean, but when it lands on the Flyknit, it's all kind of like broken up and staticky. I mean, obviously, it's just the nature of the material, but I still don't love it. Moving around to the heel of the sneaker, you've got a white pull tab with VaporMax written in 3M. Moving down the shoe, you get to my least favorite part of the VaporMax, the mouth guard. I've made that joke before, I really didn't need to make it again, but man, in this clear colorway, it really looks like a mouth guard. It's not a bad midsole, it's not pretty, it's definitely more durable than I think everyone was expecting when the VaporMax first released, But I mean, it's just not the most comfortable thing in the world. And I know that varies from person to person, and like I've said in every other one of my VaporMax reviews, it just doesn't fit well on my foot. And finally, moving to the bottom of the sneaker, you see more of that midsole and outsole combination. I mean, I've definitely grown to like it more than I did, but I still don't love it. One last thing to keep in mind is that when you're going up and down stairs, you can catch stairs, so make sure to watch these ridges because I've fallen quite a few times. The first time was definitely the shoe's fault. The other times, I should have known better. Overall, the white colorway of the Nike Off-White VaporMax is probably my second favorite VaporMax ever. I've said this in the past, but the Flyknit upper is really the only thing that redeems this sneaker for me, and when it looks this good, I had to pick it up. I mean, these blue laces on this white upper, they look great. The white Nike Off-White VaporMax released about a month ago and obviously has since sold out. So if you're trying to grab a pair for yourself, you're definitely gonna have to pay resale, and to be completely honest with you, it's not pretty. But if you're in the market for an Off-White VaporMax, you definitely can't go wrong. Now that we've got the review out of the way, let's throw these guys on feet and see how they look. I'd love to hear your thoughts on the white colorway of the Nike Off-White VaporMax and which one of the three released colorways is your favorite. And as always, thank you so much for watching. Please make sure to give this video a big thumbs up if you liked it, subscribe if you haven't yet, and I'll see you all in the next one.